Hey everyone, Charlie here. Welcome to another episode of One Cup of Japan as we are leaving this creepy ass bike parking lot. Osaka. いいですか? すいません。So, actually I really hate this parking lot because usually when I'm here it's really early in the morning, right? And really early in the morning or late at night, there's a lot of cops around the station right now. There's the Cuppa attached to the station, but anyway, so it always reminds me of like, I don't know, it has the feel of like a Skynet Terminator making factory that's been like, had an irrational fear of such things since I was a very small child. So anyway, today we are in Honmachi here, like I've alluded to, pretty much right on top of JR Sabae station. We're gonna walk past it here in a minute. If we look across the street here at this hotel, this is Alpha One. You can find them all over the place, I think, but this one's interesting for me because this is where I spent my first night when I was in Sabae, because for really ridiculous reasons anyway, when I got to Sabae, my apartment wasn't ready yet. So the very first night I spent over there, and it was okay. It's like 3,500 yen for the night, and had Wi-Fi, and after 2 weeks of training, it was the first time I had to sort of just relax and be by myself without having to do any lesson plans or anything like that. So it's always kind of interesting to come back and see it. Of course, on that day, well, let's just say it wasn't a day like today, where the sun is shining, right? There was just so much snow and it was a terrible, terrible thing. But anyhow, so reason we're in this part of the city is, well, one, that I never really come here unless I'm going to JR, and when I do end up coming here, and I ride the train this way towards like Takefu and Tsuruga, places like that, and like the sort of on my way out of the prefecture when I'm going to Osaka or something like that, I always see, is this thing on? Yes it is, okay. I always see there's a temple up here, a little ways that I've never been to. Maybe it's this one. Yeah, it's literally this one that I'm walking past right here. Hakusan Jinja. Or Shiroyama, I'm not sure which way it's pronounced in this case, but anyway. There is a, look at how old this building is next door. Go off to the side here. But anyhow, the characters on that sign right back there said White Mountain, which can be pronounced Shiroyama. There is a Shiroyama, a small mountain, like kind of the size of the mountain I was hiking during the last one Cuppa. And but there's another one that's sort of far from the distance, which you can see from the peak of that mountain from last time. Same characters, but it's pronounced Hakusan, as in also the White Mountain. It's really pretty here, yeah? But anyway, well, this is a lot closer to get to. So before I get started today, I want to talk about your questions, of course. I have a bunch of really good questions that I'm really interested in answering. And before I get to your questions, I want to talk about something really unique that happens here. There's no water in this basin for cleansing your hands or your mouth before you offer a prayer. Anyway, really beautiful here. There's not even like a catch for coins. So anyhow, let's get out of here. I feel a little creepy. And so yeah, back home, right, when I was driving all the time, it wasn't terribly unusual for me to, what should I say, to be a little generous myself. Anyway, to get a little aggravated when I was driving, right? Especially when I had to go into the city for meetings with the company I was writing for. And, you know, anyway, like traffic and people driving like what I perceive to be jerks and things like that. So, and you know, I get frustrated and stuff like that. I'm thinking in my head like, oh, I just want to kick your fucking teeth in. Like, well, sorry, that was violent language. But here, sometimes I get that way when I'm on a bicycle. Sometimes you'll get stuck behind somebody on a bicycle who is like riding at the same speed at which they would basically like walk. And so it's a very unique, strange thing to realize that I'm getting road rage on the back of a cycle. Let's cross the street here and I'll take you over to like one of the more business-filled areas of the city near the station here. But yeah, so I just had sort of like cycle rage on my way to the station for like a good, I don't know, 5 miles. I was just like grumbling to myself and thinking really awful things. So let's dive into our questions here. Let's get out our paper notebook because it's 2016 and I am nothing if not a futurist. Getting lots of awesome looks, of course. Okay, so the first question comes to us via Twitter from, let's see, Health Sings, I think. Yeah, Health Sings is the name. So, what are your thoughts on futons? Now, I love them. I love them. It's been a long time, I guess, now since I did a tour of my apartment. But basically, the way my apartment is right now, there's like a... the bed is raised about 3.5 feet off the ground. And on top of that, there's like a... yeah, there's basically a futon on top of that, right? And underneath it, there's like a crawl space so you can store stuff in there. And actually, I hate that particular setup for futons, but if you're talking about like futon that's placed on like a tatami mat, like when you go to a ryokan, honestly, the best sleeps I've ever had here are when I've gone to a ryokan and slept on a tatami mat in a futon. So, conditionally, I love futons. Let's go over this way for a second. I want to take you up here too because it's sort of interesting. Like I said, that this part of the city is like, there are a lot of like, it's where you find like a ton of like the more chain-like businesses just because it's so close to the station. But there's also an area here that just has like a really old style road, which I really, really love. And I've never caught it on camera, I think. I showed this in last video, but there's a gentleman over here. Looks like he's working the field to get it ready for the rice. But these other fields, which are still sort of left cropless, are just like glass and so, so, so beautiful, particularly near sunset and sunrise, just the reflections on the water. There's the mountains out there in the distance, and you can see this field right here ahead of us already has. There's a small one here, which is just looks really yucky. But this one right here already has some young sprouts in it that will eventually turn into rice. Love it. So, onward with our questions. From Jacob Foster on YouTube. What is my fondest memory in life? Now, I'm sure it would depend on my mood and if I was feeling nostalgic, the answer to this question, but at this very moment, the thing that springs to mind when I think about, you know, the sort of happiest I've ever been or like the happiest time I can remember, it's going to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, which we frequented a lot when I was a kid because my family are big history buffs. My dad and my uncle in particular, and they sort of instilled that in us. Probably one of the reasons why I ended up going into a type of history when I was getting my university degree. But you know, we would... so basically I grew up in places like Williamsburg and Gettysburg and Lexington and Concord up in Massachusetts, places like that, you know, those really sort of important. Now what is this over here? Across the road, don't die. But anyway, while we were at these places, what I'm trying to show you guys, there's a very old style walkway here. Not old style necessarily, but just compared to the rest of the city, like this this irrigation ditch that runs perpendicular to the road here. And this is sort of like one of the old style things I was telling you I wanted to see because I really love, particularly if I manage to get up especially early for my morning run, come down here and I really love it. And then I can sort of pretend like I can race the trains a little bit too. It's beautiful here. So, you know, when we go to Gettysburg, all of us would buy... That was a very cute farm girl. Farm woman, for the record. I'm not being a creep. At least I don't think I am. Completely lost my train of thought. No, so we would, you know, my cousin Kara and my cousin Rachel, I don't know if she was born yet, but anyway, my cousin and my older brother Ryan, you know, we all got cap guns. And we would have these cap gun battles in the hotel and just run around the third or the fourth floor, wherever we were at the time, and just sort of shooting at each other. And I think, as the story goes, though my dad tells it better because he was of an age where, you know, his memory was better. Basically, I guess there was a stranger kid who kind of came around the corner and decided he was going to play with us, you know, all of us kids who knew each other and knew, like, our level of intensity and our screaming and our shooting and all that. And so I guess this little kid comes around the corner and sees my older brother and my cousin, and we scream after him, we take off shooting at him and stuff like that. And konnichiwa. So he just scared the hell out of the kid, and the kid takes off like a bat out of hell type thing, you know. And so right now, as I'm feeling nostalgic because my family's going to spend a couple weeks in Disney World for my mother's graduation, and I can't be there. So anyway, that's where my mind is. It's just, I think really fondly of those times, you know. And I love Gettysburg, and I love the smell of the cap guns, that the smell of saltpeter, and it almost always smelled like burnt bacon to me when I was a kid. So anyway, okay, so that's that. Let's move on to the next one here before I linger on this too long and start to get a little weepy. This next song, going crazy. What is that down here? Very green. I like green things. Next question also comes to us from Jacob Foster on YouTube. Do you have plans to independently publish your works? Yeah, I mean, probably because, like, the dream is, right? And I've told people this before. And if you're a writer, a musician, or whatever, I'm sure you've had similar thoughts. But basically, like, the dream is that I finish a manuscript, I get it edited, I put it out there in, like, more traditional means, right? And the publishing company sees it and they love it. They pay me a huge advance. I can pay off my student loans and then I live the life, right? Like, that's the dream, of course. But, of course, the thing about dreams is that, well, you know. So, yeah, I mean, I think most likely I will probably have to independently publish my work at first. Hopefully with a stroke of luck, a big stroke of luck, you know, people will take notice and read it and like my point of view on things. Now see, this is interesting. And I always really, well, I've just said it's interesting, so that would be redundant what I was about to say, but as we move away from the rice fields and just across the way, there's a freaking Mossburger and a Valor and Nokonomiyaki shop. Just seems sort of juxtaposed, you know? But, so I mean, most definitely, I'm gonna try to publish by traditional means at first, probably, for whatever reason. And then from there, yeah, I'll probably have to move on to self-publishing, just as a matter of necessity, I guess. But yeah, I will certainly let everybody know, let the world know as loud as I can, when it is time, when I have published through whatever medium ends up being my medium. So, anyhow, thanks for the questions, Jacob. Always appreciate your questions, and thanks, of course, to, excuse me, Health Sings for that first question too. I forgot to thank you, because I'm a bad person. Himitsu, who is such a supportive, I mean, all of you guys clearly are supportive if you're sending me questions when I ask them. But Himitsu, he really, really, I believe you're a he. Also, funny story about this next person. Himitsu, handle Himitsu. I had a dream that Emily, Wikipedia and I met this person in real life, which I don't even know what he looks like. What they look like, I should say. So anyway, basically, I dreamt that this person, like, all the comments he's left over on the burrow, or he's left on the main channel here, that he was doing so from prison, and then he got out, and his wish once he got out of prison was to meet us, which is, of course, a horribly vain thought to have, that gets out of prison, the first thing he wants to do is meet us, right? But anyway, his question is, how is Fukui seen by other Japanese people / foreigners, and how do you view it differently? Sorry, I'm distracted by this large family. Let's cross the street. And okay, so how is Fukui seen by other Japanese people or other foreigners, and how is it different for me, right? As far as Japanese people go, people who haven't lived here, you know, I think basically the general reaction is, why would I ever come to Fukui, right? Like, I have a friend up in Kanazawa who's like, yeah, if you ever want to meet, like, we can just come and meet in Kanazawa because there's nothing to do in Fukui. And I think probably that is, yeah, that's the general impression I get from people. Now that said, people who have come here, like businessmen from Tokyo, for example, who I've met when I've gone to my favorite izakaya, will say, like, hands down, like, the food in Fukui is the best, right? So whether or not they're just saying that to, like, make the master feel good, I don't know, but take it for what it's worth. Now, as far as foreigners go, well, I can give you a personal anecdote. My brother, my older brother, when he came over here, I guess, oh shit, what would it have been? January. Up until he came over here, like, beforehand, he was like, oh, I'm coming over to Japan, but if you want to meet me, we're going to the one in the main cities, right? I'm not fucking coming to Fukui, of all places, like, why would I, type thing? And you know, that was, like, a lot of what I experienced at first from people, when I was like, hey, why don't you come down and visit me instead of making me always going to have to visit you, type thing. But then, of course, my brother did end up coming, and he had a good time. But I think, by and large, the perception of other foreigners is they have none. Unless people are really, really knowledgeable about Japanese prefectures or history or things like that, like, they may not even know Fukui's a place. I didn't know it was a place until I was assigned here, type thing, you know? And I think probably Rachel and June recently published a video where they were like, Well, yeah, they called Fukui the most underrated prefecture in all of Japan. And I think maybe that sort of captures the general feelings about Fukui pretty well. And yeah, Rachel said the same thing too, was that, like, she didn't know about Fukui until, I think, they were on a work assignment for a travel company or something, and they're making that video. And they came here, and they're like, oh, so I guess they're coming back. They enjoyed it so much. So hopefully I'll get to sting on. Yes, okay. So hopefully I'll get to meet up with them, because, well, that would be cool, wouldn't it? So I want to go. No, we shouldn't go up to the main road. It's going to be too loud. But, so I hope that effectively answers that question. And, you know, of course, that's why I get so excited, like, in 10 days? Oh, just about 2 weeks, actually. 2 weeks from yesterday, Nippon Culture Quest and Hide in Osaka are coming here to Fukui so that I can show it off to them. And then I think maybe Pickles the Gaijin's coming too, but he's being kind of non-committal, so I can't say for sure. But anyway, whoever shows up, I'll be happy. Be happy, happy. Here's a karaoke place. Maneki Neko. Maneki Neko, by the way, if you don't know, is well, that cat you see up there with the paw up, it's beckoning to you, right? Because in Japan, this is how you say, come here. Well, not like this, but, you know, like, you wave your hand. I like that kind of thing. So, question number next. Take a look at our notepad. From Michelle Garcia. I don't remember you mentioning the Kyoto move. What are you going to study there? ideally, I'll be studying journalism, or at least something in media or mass communications. More on that soon, but yeah, it all depends on if I can get into a good program, if there is a good program, because I don't really want to have to go to Tokyo, because I don't really like Tokyo. Next question. Granny, please share a few memorable stories with us, either teacher, flirt, or everyday life moments. Okay. In the interest of time, Heartful Mansions, cute little apartment building. Now what is over there? Oh, there's a Lawson. Oh, okay. Soba shop, chika soba. So here's kind of like the old style roads I was talking about, right? That we came down here to see and then I completely veered off of. Older style roads, of course, not like Gion olds. Let's get away from this guy. He's weed whacking his way to. Oh man, damn. Ugh. So grumpy. Now you can see, here's that sort of old style irrigation ditch, right? That runs along the road, and that's where we were before, way up there. And it just sort of keeps going this way. Thing said and done, I suppose it's a little underwhelming, isn't it? But, granny, okay. Share a few moments, either, what was it? Teacher, flirt, or everyday life. Okay, well that gives me a lot to choose from. The first thing that jumps to mind. I have this little girl. Not my little girl, she is a student. She comes to me, I see her, well, her family comes to me, all said and done, I have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 students from the same family, split between a couple kids and a couple moms. And yeah, this little girl, who I've probably talked about her a little bit before, but she's so bright. I think she's 6, turning 6. And anyway, you know, so I see her so often. And because I see her so often, her class, and she takes private lessons, like her classes are a bit more, I can shape them more specifically to her, right? So more with her whims, more with her learning style, things like that, than I can say if she's in a class of 4 other students or something like that. But, so anyway, what that ends up meaning is we get to do a lot of creative things with clay and sand and beads and construction paper and, you know, anything you can think of, really. And so she came to class one day. Check out this garden here. This looks like one of the private gardens that probably a couple different people rent. Looks like got some dill over there. Soybeans? This might be Goya. I'm not sure what kind of citrus plant that is. Usually maybe. But anyway. And so beforehand, you know, she told me how she wanted clay and how during the next class she wanted to play with clay, and that she really hoped that I would bring her a snack, right? And she really wanted like a chocolate strawberry kind of snack. And I said, okay. And so sure enough, I next class comes in and we practice like kind of like going to a convenience store, kind of, not a convenience store, but kind of like an ice cream shop language, like, oh, can I have 1 strawberry ice cream, please? Sure, here you are, thank you very much, like that kind of language, and practicing numbers, like how much is it? It's $5, 5 yen, whatever. And you know, so she's thrilled because we're playing with this clay. And, you know, I give her, like, these really, really delicious, like, strawberry chocolate snacks that were shaped like, what the hell were they shaped? Hello Kitty. Not just Hello Kitty, but Sanrio characters. And, you know, so whatever. She's happy. She's sitting at the table while we're playing with the clay, and she's munching on these things. She's kicking her little feet, and she's just so happy, you know? And so she doesn't, And so I just take it for what it is. She looks happy. She doesn't say much else. There's no thank you or anything like that, which is fine. So the class ends, and I feel pretty good. You know, I feel pretty good about it because the class went well. She was learning. She's having a good time for the 2 hours she was there. And, you know, that's, I did my job and I did it well. And so the next week I don't see her. No, the next week I do see her. I'm sorry, what I mean to say is I see her next week. And this time, you know, I think we're making necklaces, beads. And, but I don't bring her a snack. And she's like, well, where's my chocolate strawberry snack? You know, and I said, well, you can't have it every week. You know, you gotta be careful. You gotta be healthy and stuff like that, you know? And, so, you know, she, as 5-year-old girls, 6-year-old girls are wont to do, she sort of shrivels her little face and, you know, makes it clear that she's not terribly happy with this turnout. And then a few moments go by and she says to me, you know, you kind of, same thing with kids, right? Like they turn on a dime and so suddenly you see like the clouds clear from her face and the sun come out and she looks at me and she says, it's okay, you're my friend, right? And she leans over and just goes, gives me this completely unexpected little kiss on my cheek, and then she giggles. And I'm just like, ah, you know, I feel, yeah, man, so, I'm not sure even what else to say about it other than that makes it worth it, you know, those sort of connections with your kids. I love my kids, you know, so yeah, I hope that will suffice for a story. I don't even know where we are. I know we're back. There's a train station over there. There's that hotel. Here's this fellow cleaning, what is some very stinky poo-poo fertilizer off the wheels of his tractor. Now this is a very interesting looking building. House over here, this sort of tan, kind of tan creamsicle colored building over here. And that doesn't look very Japanese, doesn't it? It's kind of a South American, I'd say South American, but maybe Floridian or even Mexican look to it, to my eyes anyway. But anyway, yeah, I guess that's my, at least from teaching, my favorite, or not my favorite, but it's the memory that most readily springs to mind because it is such a good one for me. There's a choo-choo coming. Yes. Let's get it on. Let's get it on camera. My insides do not feel good at the moment, which is always fun. Oh, there's that guy with the dog again down there. Probably wonder what the hell is this guy doing. Comes, looks like a local. Yep. Is there another one gonna be coming this way? No, it looks like we're gonna be clear in a second. I'm thinking, whoa. Just not standing so close, I suppose. But yeah, so. Thanks as always, guys, for the questions as we near the end of our cuppa here. If you have any others or you'd like to respond to those that I answer today, please, of course, let me know in the comments below or get at me on Twitter, on Facebook, Snapchat, Tumblr, and now on BeMe. Any way you want to get a hold of me, this is a cute little okonomiyaki shop I've never been to before. 2 p.m. to 9 p.m. close today. So anyway, yeah, thanks, guys, always for watching. Let's take your last sip. And I'll see you all very soon indeed. Cheers.